Hey, how's it going? Mike here, one go short play. Playing Bob or B.O.B. B.O.B. for the Sega Mega Drive. Now, just first and foremost, my apologies if the sound is at all out on this. Every time I do a session of games, I have to re-plug in my microphone and pad because I'm limited with USB spaces on this computer, and one by one they're all dying. It's like 6-7 years old, I think. 6 years old, this computer, something like that. 2009, so yeah, 6 years old. But you know, it's hanging in there and it's doing the best it can, so you know, so am I. Basically, yeah, every time I do it, I've got to readjust the sound and kind of figure it out. And relearn how to plug in this microphone, which is no mean feat, I can tell you. Right, now another game I borrowed off my mate Steve when I was a kid. A teenager. Was B.O.B. And I quite enjoyed it. What I found about it was something about the scrolling and the animation was a little bit... it wasn't organic enough for me liking. You might see what I mean. It is a robot after all. But there was just something a bit weird and static about the way he moved. That's kind of cool. I think it was when he jumped up. Was it a jump thing that got me with? Can I jump up and grab? He jumps up and grabs and he wiggles his fingers to move along, and it was kind of cool, but it got me wick a bit. Right, let's explore. I'm not sure what he's doing there. I think he's hiding. Let's explore. I can't really remember playing. I did play this quite a bit, but I can't really remember it. I love all the charming little animations that he's got going on though. Although it does feel a little bit... not very smooth and slick. I think that was one of the animations that got me with, but that's good. Yeah, I like stuff like that. I don't really like the way he moves. I know he's a robot, but something about the robotiness is a little bit too static. That's just my personal taste. See, it's charming, it's good, it's actually quite nice, but it's the fact that the rest of the body's doing nothing. Seems a bit lazy. Do you mind? I'm trying to explain the animations of the game. Anyway, let's just play it. Because I remember it being quite fun to play. Although, not as good as, in my opinion, as people made it out to be. He's a funky little character, isn't he? Whoa! We don't play with that, do we? He is a funky little character. I mean, we never saw him again in any other games, I don't think, after this. Answers on a postcard, if I'm wrong. Do let me know, I'm sure... if you were in the other game, someone would tell me. Now. Yeah, just something about some of the animations I didn't really get along with. Still cool though. Good little platformer. Let's go this away. What's up there? Have we been up there? We came down from up there. See, I'm hitting the jump button and he's just sliding off the edge. Also, that walk is really slow to get moving. It's just more of what we've already seen. What's this? Let's go into it. Yo, can do. Oh, he's icy. He's got attitude. He's got attitude like most other Mega Drive game characters. He is like a teenage robot, according to the intro. And his dad's lent in the car. And it's all going a bit wrong. So yeah, they've got to give him a bit of attitude, I suppose. But there's a lot of this attitude in Mega Drive games, which was kind of cool at the time. A lot of wearing caps backwards and whatnot. But, and saying dude. But, really? That's cool. Okay, let's wander. That first level wasn't as much of a challenge as I remember it being. And that said, I don't remember much about this game. Oh, cool. I thought I'd just swap me 3 bullet for 1 bullet, but it seems to have done something else. You see, it's a little bit non-responsive. When I landed in that pink lava, I just flashed. It's like, yeah, you're fine here, but you will lose energy. I mean, it tells you what you need to know, I guess. And I should be grateful it's not, like, throwing me about the place. You know, like, sometimes we get stuck in lava, you start leaping around. And makes it difficult to control to get out of the lava. I should be grateful that it doesn't do that. But, I don't know. I quite like the prompt. That you could end with me, huh? I quite like the prompt of being, like, bounced around by the lava. It just felt a bit lacking to lava. Oh, I see the reference. That's clever. See what they did there. See, I don't remember this bit. So I must have been rubbish at this game. Because I don't remember that. I mustn't have got off the first room, which was admittedly tiny. Maybe I didn't play this very much, maybe the controls. Maybe that got on me wick enough to not play it very much. That said, I did only borrow it off my mate. If I'd bought it, I'd have probably played it through. But I think I borrowed it along with like 10 other games at the time. And you know, when you find a couple that you really like, the other ones don't get played. I think this one didn't get played that much. It's kind of good though. I'm quite liking it, no. Progress. Let's make some progress. Oh, hang on. See, we're back here now. Or we're back in this sort of environment. This place looks totally weird, dude. See that kind of totally Bill and Ted thing going on. Oh, no. Oof, that wasn't looking. Oh, right in the face. Alright, that's it. Yeah, you know, it's kind of cool. It's not, that is actually a baddie that's killing me. It's not as cryptic as a lot of platformers are in terms of where you need to go. I want that. I want it. Why can't I take a running jump? It takes a bit of a while for them to get started moving. Oh, but it's not as cryptic as some platformers are in terms of where it wants you to go. You know, there's always an option open. No, oh, that was a chance in there a bit, wasn't it? There's always an option open. See, I don't remember that alien bit, but I feel like I remember this bit. Ooh. That's a bit cheap. Oh, I can shoot through the wall too, so it's not so cheap after all. Oh, come on, that is cheap. Oh, really? Yeah, the controls aren't... They're great. They're good, but they're not that good, you know? They're not good enough to handle that particular platform. What's going on there? Step ladder that I can't get to. Oh well, lift it is then. That seems to be the only option now. And, oh hello. How about something that allows me to shoot down there? Oh, I see, I've got to get it. Ah, yes. Or at least take the chance of getting hit. Right, so you can't, walk up there, but you can't go in there. Okay, that's fine by me. I'm not quite sure what that's about. Oh, I like that. I like all the guns. It just feels a little bit sharp the way he moves, but that's okay. I've seen much, much worse. I've just run out of the bullet I needed to kill him. Oh, what are the chances of that? That was nasty. Remember that as well, when you get killed, you kind of explode into your component parts. Which is kind of cool. But again, quite cheap from an animation point of view, because all you've got to do is break up the sprite. You know, there's a lot of sort of cheap animation in this game. It's like the idea, it's like the idea of a robot character has been totally exploited for cheap animations. Which I think I have a little bit of an issue with. Although back then I couldn't have done any better, so I'm not complaining. Maybe these days I could. So I do. I should probably elaborate there. I do art for games as part of my day job. But back then I couldn't have done this. Or anything as good as this. Ah! Oh, come on! Man! That sucked the fat one. I'm not going back down there. That's just a waste of lives, isn't it? Isn't it, eh? Now I remember it being a bit frustrating like this. And I remember getting quite impatient at areas like this. Which I always have done, to be fair. And I remember not remembering... Oh, come on, really? Not remembering obstacles like that. Which kind of are essential to remember. To progress. It's one of those games where you need to remember what's coming. You know, to progress. You'll never do it on your first go, you know. Which I'm not sure I like. I think Steve Benway said something similar about a game design needs to kind of... It needs to give you a chance, even on your first go, you know? You can't... I said I wouldn't come down here, didn't I? A game shouldn't kill you before... A game shouldn't allow you to progress based on remembering your last go, you know? Well, I don't know, there are certain games that are an exception to that rule. But this isn't one of them. Everything in this game should give you some sort of warning. He said it was the sign of a bad game, wasn't it? I'm not quoting him there. But I kind of agreed with him, sign of a bad game, that, oh yeah, something's gone a bit wrong there. Oh, that was weird. That kills you without warning. I think some games are designed that way. But this one, this isn't the model, you know. Oh. You shouldn't get punished in this game for not knowing what's coming next. You should kind of be allowed to deal with it. Really? And the controls are really getting on my way now. They are quite sluggish, actually. When you get to these kind of parts, where it gets... I wouldn't say intricate, it's not particularly intricate. It's not as intricate as it as I'm making it look, you know? In a lot of other games, that network of platforms will be dead easy to negotiate. Oh, really? Oh, really? Oh, man. But in this one, you've got to make a meal of it, you know? Anyway, I've been playing this far too long, and I'm not really enjoying it. That was Bob, or B.O.B. for the Sega Mega Drive. It's not a bad game, it's just... I don't know, I never warmed to it, and I still haven't. Okay, thanks for watching. See you later.